I was in Cannes in 2002 for a film I'd shot the year before. I'd been flown down to do some interviews, and I was alone. And I'm not really good at going out alone, but there was a party on the beach of the Carlton Hotel where I was staying, so I went down to have a mosey. And I'm standing at the bar, and I turn around, and I find myself standing next to Harvey Weinstein. So the first thing I thought is, yes, this is Harvey Weinstein. This is my opportunity. Which is funny because I'd heard a lot of stories by this point, but is somebody that powerful in an industry where you're trying to make a name for yourself, it's pretty exciting. I mean, it must be the same with the television industry. So I panicked because he started to look over my shoulder. You know that thing where people start looking over your shoulder and you realize that you've got to say something interesting? So I said, my boyfriend screen tested for you last night, which was true, in New York. And he said, yes, and he did a great job. He's very talented. And I was like, oh my God, I can't wait to tell my boyfriend, Johan Griffith, that he did a great job. And the next thing I'm hearing is, I'd like to touch your boobs. And I'm like, hey, I'm sorry. I want to touch your boobs, and I'd like to touch you, and I'd like to kiss you. Why don't you go into the bathroom and I'll follow you? And it was the first thing that came into my mind was, surely he knows that I'm not that type of girl, which I feel terrible about now, because who is that type of girl, really? Nobody wants to think they're that type of girl. And I was like, he's not going to do this to me. Surely he can see that I'm an intelligent person. I'm on his political side. And it just happened incredibly fast. He kept saying, go to the bathroom, go to the bathroom, go to the bathroom. And I kept trying to extricate myself. Bear in mind, I wasn't in a situation of danger because there were people all around us. So it's not like some of the other girls that had horrific times with him coming towards them in a small hotel room. But in my case, as I extricated myself, I said, yes, maybe I'll go to the bathroom, maybe. And he said, let's hope your boyfriend's career goes well. And that has stayed with me forever. And by the way, I've never claimed that our careers went badly because of that. But it's repugnant to me that he would say that, because we all know what he meant, right? Oh, and my boyfriend did not get the film.
And do you think there was a connection between you're not getting the film and what you said?
I don't think actors can say that, and I think it's anybody in our industry I would feel horrible and cringy to say, I don't think he got it because of that. I think there were probably a million. There's only one person for each role, and there's a million actors. So maybe they went with somebody of a different ethnicity, a different age, But he used the fact that he knew that my boyfriend was testing and that I obviously wanted him to get the role.
But the common theme here is that Harvey Weinstein appeared to be using the very power that you recognised he had to wield this kind of control over women, didn't he? The question that people who are not in Hollywood have all been asking is, why are so many women, many of whom are very intelligent, you know, you and I have known each other a long time, you're very intelligent, strong-minded, independent woman, why did nobody before last week ever raise their head above the parapet and say, this is what this guy does?
Well, let me ask you this question. Who would we raise our heads to? One imagines there's some kind of omnipresent authority, right? I can't go to the police. He didn't do anything legally wrong. Everybody in Hollywood wants to get a film made. That's what we're all trying to do. So if you think about anyone you go and say, but this happened and it was awful, and it's not, it's throwing a spanner in the works of what they're trying to get done. So what I think happened was everybody needed Harvey Weinstein, and so everybody was prepared to kind of imagine that it maybe wasn't as bad as they thought. I don't think anybody said go away and have sex with this man, but he had what everybody wanted. He was in a position of power. So I remember talking to people, and sometimes we'd have a few drinks, and sometimes you'd start telling your story, and you'd suddenly go, oh, shoot, I really hope this person isn't... Because I know of girls who told other girls to be careful, and then the girls went in, had whatever they had to do with Harvey, and told Harvey about the other girls. And Harvey called the other girls and said, don't you ever talk bad about me again. It's so... Can you imagine that Orwellian kind of just fear, or almost something like World War II or something with the French? You weren't sure who was your friend and who wasn't. When I heard about this, somebody emailed me and said, "Have you heard Harvey's gone down?" And I went, "Yes." And you know what my first thought was? So glad it's not me. And then I went, "Hold on a second. Hold on. Wait. Did I just think that?" And then I heard that the other girls, some people were saying, "Well, do we believe these girls or not?" And then I realized I have to speak, because I have to make sure that people understand that these girls are telling the truth.
Right. Yeah.
Because that's we've got to be as many as possible. And I understand that Alyssa Milano is also doing something online, not directly with Harvey, but saying, retweet this and say me too if you have experienced that kind of sexual harassment. So it's not a I noticed after my Telegraph article, I looked at some of the comments, which I know you should never do, but there were some people saying, "Oh, it's all easy for you now to jump on the bandwagon." No, we have to jump on the bandwagon now. Yeah, otherwise, we're saying that the other girls might not be telling the truth.
Yeah, I think also this idea of trying to somehow steer the blame to the victims is utterly ridiculous. Clearly,
I actually printed some comments out that I thought were interesting, anonymous comments online about how, well, you know, it always takes two to tango.
Where it gets complicated.
Did you hear what I just said?